And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the value of salah to be one of the five pillars of Islam. Why is it so heavy on Day of Judgment? Why are we going to be stopped at that station on Day of Judgment? Because of that. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam قال بني الإسلام على خمس. Islam was established on five pillars. The first one, شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله. To bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. ثم قال وإقام الصلاة. To establish salah. And then everything will come after that. Immediately, إقام الصلاة. To establish salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam قال بين المرء والكفر والشرك ترك الصلاة. The criteria is between the individual, man or woman, and committing shirk, sharing partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or kufr, committing that infidelity, which means the kufr, disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to abandon as salah. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. The covenant that distinguishes between us and them, the disbelievers, is as-salah. Whoever abandons salah فقد كفر is indeed committed kufr, disbelief, an act of disbelief. From these ahadith, our ulama, they gave salah a very, very special position in our deen. What's the position of salah in our deen? And why is it so heavy that much on the Day of Judgment? That would be the first station. And the first question that you're going to be asked about on Judgment Day in regard to ibadah and worship would be as-salah. Number one, because it's the main pillar of Islam. Once you say La ilaha illallah, what is next? What comes next? Five times a day. Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala was sent to Yemen, down south. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he commanded him when he goes there, قَالَ يَا مُعَادِ When you go to the people, you're coming to people of Ahl al-Kitab. These are people who follow another book. It's Christians and Jews. So when you call them, فَإِذَا دَعَوْتُمْ فَدْعُهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَشْهَدُوا أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَنَا مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهُ First thing you tell them about, you invite them to, is to witness and testify there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. فَإِنْ أَجَابُوكَ لِذَلِكَ If they obey you to this one, if they listen to that, فَأَعْلِمْهُ Let them know. And Allah قَدْ فَرْضَ عَلَيْهِمْ خَمْسَ صَلَوَاتٍ فِي الْيَوْمِ وَالْلَيْلَةِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory upon them to pray five times a day. فَإِنْهُمْ أَجَابُوكَ لِذَلِكَ If they obey you for this, then the next and the following pillar. So the first thing after shahada comes salah. Once a person becomes a Muslim, the first thing they need to learn that they need to maintain now five times to dedicating five times for devotion. Standing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship and ibadah. The second thing, the salah we learn is so significant because it was made an obligation in the Sana' al-Sabi'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he received that command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala between the Jama'ah with no translated interpreter in the middle. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who spoke to Muhammad directly sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to receive that obligation of salah. This salah we know that it's so important that a public call was made mandatory in order to establish the timing for this salawat. What do we call this public call? Adhan. Show me any other ibadah that has this public call. Fasting, doesn't have public call? In Muslim countries, actually they launch cannons. But it happens only once or twice a year. Once at the beginning of the month, and one at the end of the month. And that's it. After that, it's over. But this is not from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Didn't have any cannons back then. But Salah has five daily prayers, Adhan. When it comes to zakah, it was left for your conscience as a believer. No one tells you that it's time to pay zakah. It is you who calculate your zakah. It is you who know when the time for zakah becomes due. And it is you who is going to be paying that zakah out. No one's going to be chasing you around. So it's you who will be calling for that. When it comes to hajj, we know that the hajj comes once a year. But there's no adhan for it. Come to hajj. It's you who make the decision, I need to go to Hajj this year, inshallah ta'ala. But when it comes to the salah, someone else is calling for the salah. It's not you who says, I'm going to make the salah or the adhan. No, the adhan, whether you make it or not, it is going to be called. And the call, calling all people to come for that salah. And subhanAllah, ya akhwan, wallahi al-adhan, lahu yani, lahu ajab. And I speak with so many non-Muslims and make so many presentations about Islam. And one of the things that fascinates people who visit Muslim countries is I ask them, because I usually ask them if they visit Muslim countries or not. So we so many people went there for tourism or for something else. Eventually I say, what was the most fascinating thing that you still remember from these times that you spent there? And almost like in an unanimous agreement, one of the fascinating moments or fascinating time that they remember from there is the adhan. Yaqul adhan. I remember a couple, wallahi, when they were talking to me about their stay in Morocco, and جلست المغرب مدة من الزمان, فتحدثوا لي, they said that the best time that they used to remember was the adhan. And the best adhan to hear and listen to, guess which one? Fajr. Now you hear that from non-Muslims. Some Muslims today they say, it's too loud, please make it in Allah or whatever. And these people, they miss adhan al-fajr. When I was talking to them and they were describing to me adhan al-fajr, that when they used to wake up for it, wallahi, they were crying. And they were in their 50s. You can see the tears in their eyes, they were choking. So oh, that was so beautiful, that was so fascinating, that was so amazing, so majestic, magical moment in their lives. Do you know that some people, they become Muslims just because of hearing the adhan? Some people just heard that, that makes them Muslims. And I do remember watching actually or reading a story of someone in Jinan Riyadh in Saudi Arabia. One of those visitor workers who came, I believe, from Asia, I think from Philippines. And he became Muslim just because of the adhan. One time he was walking in the market, probably his first time and when he arrives, and suddenly he said, we heard some kind of loud voice. You know how the Bedouins in Riyadh, they call adhan? They don't make adhan so beautiful, by the way. They just have that traditional, oh, or something like that. So the guy thought that was silent. Because when he saw everybody locking their doors and their stores and so on, and walking towards one direction. He thought they were going for shelter. So he started walking with them. And the guy suddenly just see, everybody just was kind of wondering, why aren't they running, you know? Because they're supposed to be rushing, running, protecting themselves, and those people were walking together and laughing and joking, chit-chatting. It didn't sound like something danger they're escaping from. So he saw them going to that kind of different structure, which was the masjid. And he saw them inside making specific, you know, rituals, going down, so he realized that this must be place of worship. And then he said a few minutes later, though people were coming back right now, opening their store, and that life went back to normal. Then probably maybe 45 minutes later, he saw the Isha now, he started here with the same voice. Oh, no, Akbar. And then suddenly people started locking their doors and going back again to the masjid. And he did the same thing with them. He said that the whole congregation, to look at this congregation, huge congregation, to be organized in this system without anybody controlling them, just hearing a siren like this, a voice like this, organizing like this, said, this is not human. This must be divine. Because human being cannot do that naturally. It must be something that is above the level of humanity that brings it to that organization, to that system.